Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Here are 7 FL Studio shortcuts you need to know. The first one I learned from Infinite, shout out to Infinite. When you're in your playlist or in song mode, if you have a pattern clip that's off the grid or audio off the grid, hit Shift Q to quantize it to the grid. He's a goat for showing us that. The second tip is if you double click in here, you can go inside the piano roll. Let's say your notes are off the grid like this. Hit either Alt Q or Control Q. The difference is Control Q snaps the notes to the snap to grid. So even if you have it in triplet timing, it will snap to triplet timing. If you change it to quarter timing or half timing, hit Control Q, will snap it to that timing. This is good for people who write in triplets, so you might not know how to quantize, and then hit Alt Q. Let me just show you quickly how to go to triplets, go to your snap to grid, go to 1/3 beat, and we're gonna draw these in kind of roughly just to show you guys how this would look. So it looks something like this. So let's say you play it a little sloppy, but you want to quantize it to triplets. Now, what most people do is they hit Alt Q, and that takes it off of the triplet timing, as you can see. So what you want to do is change your snap to grid to 1 triplet or 1/3 beat or 1/6 beat or 1/3 step, whatever. Go to 1/3 beat, hit Control Q, and it will lock it to the triplets. So that's how you quantize triplets for those who want to know. Okay, so that's Alt Q, Control Q. Next, I'm going to show you how to line up your 808s and your kicks. So here's an 808 pattern. Now let's say we have the 808 notes going all over the place. So let's change up some of these notes. So let's say your notes are like this for the 808. Now you want to copy the 808 into your kick. So most people just hit Control C, Control V. The problem is now your kick is playing the different pitches, okay? So it's going to sound different. So what you could do is hit Alt K. And then change your key to C and then change your scale to none. And just make sure it's highlighting C5 in this case and then hit accept. That will pull all those random notes down to C5. So it keeps the same timing, but it pulls it down to middle C so that it plays the original sample in its original form. So now you can stack your 808s and kicks easily. Now those still need mixing, but that's beyond this video. So the next thing you need to learn, in my opinion, is latch paste. It will help you format a lot faster. So if you go to song mode, highlight your pattern, hit Control B. It's very important that you quantize or hit Shift Q before you hit Control B, because what this does is it latch paste. Let me show you what happens. Let's say you have some audio and it's not quantized to the grid, you hit Control B, your session will become offbeat over time, okay? So this is not lined up to the grid. So what you need to do is get in the habit of making sure that before you hit Control B is that you latch, you cut the edges off of the sound. You can go to your slice tool, hit Shift, and do a right click to cut the edges off of your sound. Okay, so you can hit Control and then Control B to highlight and latch paste. So that's how you do that right there. Pretty simple. Now the next shortcut you wanna learn is, for hip hop at least, hi-hat rolls. So right here we have a pattern. We're gonna right click, go to piano roll. Let's say you wanna roll like right here. You could highlight this note, hit Control L to extend that note out, and then hit Alt U to chop it up. Change your time multiplier. And that's how you do hi-hat rolls. Okay, the next thing you could do is humanize your chords and your melody. So for example, you can go to your piano roll, go to chord stamps. Let's just draw in a chord type. Let's do B minor ninth. And let's say the notes are like this. You could hit Control L to drag it out like that. Hit Control down to pull the notes down an octave. And we could hit Shift left click to drag those notes over. Now the problem with FL by default is most people leave their velocity all the way up. So grab the ellipses tool right here, just left click, drag that up, hit Alt and left click. That will reset the volume here. Just make sure your control's on velocity. FL Studio remembers the value of the last MIDI note you added. So if you pan something or turn the volume down, it will paste that throughout every single note that you add from that point on. So this is how most people produce, but the problem is if I play softly, it gives me a different sound. So you don't want your velocity up all the time. So what you could do is go to the scripts tool and go to your wrench tool, go to the humanize script, and then mess with your time offset and your velocity offset. And that will make this more humanized as far as the feel. Now let's say you want to lower this entire velocity, but keep the velocity changes, hit Alt X, and then turn down your multiply. And it still has that human touch and timing. That script is in FL Studio, I think 21.2. Just grab the latest update. You guys should update anyway. No reason to be in the older versions of FL Studio. Lastly, I'll show you how to ungroup those chord stamps. So let's highlight these, hit Alt G to ungroup. And let's say you want to select individual notes. You could hit Control and Shift. Now, if you don't hit Alt G, what it does is you're trying to select one note at a time. Okay. And then you hit Alt G to group or whatever the group function is. You'll try to grab a chord stamp, for example, and you'll try to grab one specific note, but it keeps grabbing the entire chord. And you're like, why does it keep doing that? It's because these notes are grouped. Okay. So we need to ungroup them hitting Alt G. Okay, so now we can select individual notes. So from here, you're going to hit Control and Shift to select or deselect a note. And that will allow you to touch certain notes and not other notes. Okay, so another thing you want to learn is Alt and Shift when it comes to the playlist and the song mode. If you have audio, this is more applicable really to audio. But let's say you want to chop a transient right here. If you grab that slice tool, and even if you do Shift to do a vertical slice, you still got to like figure out how to get in there. Okay. Even if you do a regular slice, it goes crooked. You're like, what's happening? So you can hit Shift and Alt to do a vertical slice, and it allows you to do any time. So now I can go in and find the exact time I want to slice and then slice it here. Now, when you do the same thing, hit Shift to do a vertical slice, you can also right click to delete whatever is smaller. Okay. So whatever is smaller will get deleted. So in this case, you can slice off the end right there. And also you could hit Shift Alt to do that vertical slice. The last thing, which I already covered, is Control L. So let's say your notes are kind of gappy like this. You can hit Control Q to quantize. Remember, these are in triplets, so we don't want to affect these. So let's hit Control Shift, highlight just these notes, hit Control Q to quantize, hit Control L to fill out these notes. And let's say you want to restore the velocity, hit Alt, left click to restore the velocity. Okay, so that is all you need to know as far as the shortcuts. There's a lot more shortcuts, but I don't want to bog you down. If you want to learn more about FL Studio, we have a free FL Studio 21 course. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. Peace out, guys.